Hail, first city of Nigeria, my alma mater.
Hail and rejoice for the sake of truth,
where young men and women do seek for knowledge.
Hail and rejoice for the sake of knowledge,
where the nation's potentials do brood in the nest.
Hail and rejoice for her noble ideals.
Hail for city poets alone, her dreams come true.
Hail and rejoice for the giants always. My alma mater, my alma mater, noble are thy roots and thy ideals, and great art thou.
City of Nigeria, my alma mater.
Hail and rejoice for her lofty plans.
The diversity that is cited on soft green fields.
Hail and rejoice for her beauty's sake.
Hail, varsity of.
Want to most respectfully welcome you to the University of Nigeria. It is a great privilege to be here, and I want you to celebrate yourself for this wonderful opportunity you have to be here. Some of you don't feel so proud of yourself, you don't feel happy with yourself, and so you find it difficult to celebrate yourself. Can you now celebrate yourself? Well, you may think it's not necessary to celebrate yourself, but I think it is very necessary. And right now, there is someone who has made your being here very possible. And that is God Almighty, who has given you the privilege to be alive and to witness your mission come true. Can we be on our feet and celebrate God Almighty with a clap of you? You know, our God doesn't eat peas. Our God doesn't eat oil. Our God doesn't eat oil. He doesn't eat shampoo. What he does is glory. So celebrate the Lord. Maybe I should ask you to clap for God Almighty. According to the number of years you want to live on earth. Is omnipotent. Without him, there will be chaos. The one that gave us the rare privilege to be admitted. But you see, for examination, and your result come out, does not mean that you are so intelligent. You are not intelligent, but there is what is called grace. And when grace is assured, you begin to see positive things in your life. Thank you so much for celebrating our God, the one who has given us the privilege to be here. So please come out, while still standing, I would like to hand in the microphone to a man of God that is here to begin with us officially with an opening prayer. It is my privilege to welcome Pastor or Apostle Emmanuel Udechukwu. Can we give it up to him?
Things that will be taught today that you will hear. So begin to thank God for that opportunity, thank God for that privilege that you have to be here this day. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for your family members. Thank you for allowing you to be enrolled as one of the students in this great university. Bless the name of the Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Almighty Father, we thank you for this great opportunity that you've given us today. It is not by happenstance, but by circumstance that we're here today. It has been predestined before the foundations of the earth. Every single one here is under your grace. Lord, it is your grace that has seen us through. Therefore, we glorify your name in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we are all gathered here because there are informations that will be passed on to us in order to equip us to be able to survive this community, to be able to do well, come out excellently. In fact, I pray that every ears be open. I pray for quick understanding. I pray that the eyes of our understanding be enlightened this morning. In the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for the speakers, as many as we come into, you know, do one function or the other, I pray that your grace will rest upon us. Lord, as we speak as your oracle. In the name of Jesus Christ. There will be.
Thank you so very much. You may resume your seat. For those of you who may not have seats, arrangements have been made to get seats into this hall that you can sit on. But I want you to understand that the essence of this program is for your good. Therefore, it would be nice that you exercise some level of high level of patience to absorb all the information that will be coming your way this day. It is important at this point in time to mention to you that this program, which is titled Superlative Campaign for Excellence, is for all the freshers in the University of Nigeria. And today is the last day for Nsukka campus. Tomorrow we will be at UNEC to attend to all the first year students and to give them very vital information that will help them excel in this university. Any animals? Can you talk to someone by your side? Say zoo. You are not sounding like you mean it. Talk to somebody by your side. Say zoo. Okay. Now, I'm not saying that the person you are talking to is a zoo. Because I know you know what a zoo is. But the reason why I said so is that a zoo is a place where there are different animals. And in this zoo, there are animals that eat up other animals. And there are animals that make themselves available to the eating. And there are animals that resist the eating or the consumption by other animals. Therefore, they now grow to become their own kings and queens in the den. And so you know, you are actually described as lions and lionesses. But you will be given that name or called that name fully immediately after your matriculation. So the activities we are observing are activities that will take you to your matriculation. And immediately after your matriculation, you become a full lion and lioness. So for now, your names are lions, but written in pencil. So when you graduate, you become lions, but then your names will be written on an ink that will be difficult to erase, except you are committing fraud in the university. And on this note, there is a woman with a heart of gold who talked about the idea of the Superlative campaign. A woman of God who is interested in dishing out information that will guide you and help you so that your stay in this university will be a great and huge success. I believe everybody here would like to graduate in this university as someone that will be celebrated. If you believe it, can you clap for yourself? There are plans that were never composed. In the cemetery are architectural designs that the world never saw. In the cemetery are scientists that no one benefited from. In the cemetery are also men and women who died with their potentials. And here we are, on this wonderful day, alive on planet Earth, breathing, hearing ourselves, looking, watching, and observing. Don't you think that is enough miracle from God? Because we are not yet in the cemetery, we should make use of our potential so the world can benefit and the value of what personal we carry. It is on this note that I would like to recognize this great woman who has packaged this program, the Superlative Campaign for Excellence. It is my pleasure to recognize Reverend Mrs. Stella Ngozi Udejuku. Can we celebrate this great woman as I recognize her very specially? I also recognize the team, her team of great men and women who are working with her to package this program. We are going to listen to so many great people. We have the likes of the registrar, the secretary to the registrar will be coming to talk to us. And of course, with regards to you as being here, with regards to your being admitted, with regards to your graduation and your future in this university, you know, the registry department is fully handling everything concerning you. And so if you have any issue, the registry department is there for you. And so we're going to be listening to the secretary to the registrar today. And so when he comes, please open your eyes. Open your ears. Shine your eyes very well. Make sure that your friend doesn't distract you from getting the vital information. And then if you don't have a pen, please try and get one. I apologize for all those who are standing. I can assure you, we're going to start time, we're going to wrap it up. The information is so vital that at this point in time, I'll go straight into the next item, which is national anthem. Can we give honor to our country, Nigeria, by standing up to take the national anthem? Come back, Detroit, Nigeria, call obey to set our fatherland with love and strength and faith. The labor of our heroes past shall never be in vain. To serve we have and might, one nation bound in freedom, peace and unity. We'll go straight into the University of Nigerian song, because I know you are great lions and lionesses. Okay, fine. We'll have the instruments, the DJ is there to give us the sound. So, DJ, are you ready?
Men who seek for knowledge, hear and rejoice for the sake of knowledge. When nations potentials to bloom in their nest, hail and rejoice for your ideas. The varsity parasolum our dreams are true.
Appreciate your presence. Without you, there is no University of Nigeria. Do you know that?
Yes.
Without you, this place will only be a research institute. So, with you, there is a University of Nigeria. And I wish to recognize some very important persons that are here. First of all, it is important for me to recognize a woman whose vision we are riding on this afternoon. The woman that has packaged this program, Superlative Program, Campaign for Excellence. Superlative Campaign for Excellence for all the freshers. A very powerful man of God. It is my pleasure to recognize Reverend Mrs. Stella Ngozi.
Alright. The
person that led us in the opening prayer is her husband, an apostle, a man of God, anointed. Apostle Emmanuel, you can open her hands together for him. And then, seated on the left side of the coordinator of this program is a powerful man in our midst. I call him an authority because he occupies a very sensitive position in the University of Nigeria. And so because he occupies that office, he stands the chance of helping so many students to find their track on campus. The secretary to the registrar of the University of Nigeria, Nsukka. Mr. Martin, campus to come to you. Can we celebrate this day? I'd also like to specially recognize all staff of the Department of Faculties of Business Administration, where an environmental team is our business administration. Can we see that? Let's go down for now, once more. Barrister Mrs. Barrister Mrs. NN became your highly recognized. Having established this protocol, I wish to, at this point in time, go straight into the item of the day. And I wish to invite the coordinator, the one who has designed the vision for this program, up and have a platform where she'll be talking about the opening charge for this event. It's a pleasure to welcome Mrs. Stella, the Dutchman. Thank you very much,
our MC. Greatest Nigerian student! Great lioness! Some of you have not come to understand what we say. When I say lions and lioness, that means great! Lions and lionesses! Good! You are all welcome to the event. And I am so glad that we have handsome, beautiful children like you here. So you are all welcome. Without wasting your time, let me look at an opening address. Just to give a background of why we're here. Thank you. The topic says, education got to change. There is need for us to advance in life. There is need for us to address some issues around us. And without proper education, you will not be able to do the right thing. When you are well informed, you will be formed. But when you are not properly informed, you will be deformed. We are here to properly give you the real situation of this campus. That's why we are here. So Oxford Advanced Learner's Dictionary defined education as a process of teaching, training, and learning, especially in schools and colleges, to improve knowledge and develop skills. You are here to learn, to advance yourself and acquire skills that will enable you address issues in the society. That's the major reason why you're here, to groom yourself and come up with something that will solve problems in the society. According to Professor Anibong of Dissent, education is understanding what God has created and knowing how to use them. It is understanding systems, processes, procedures which God has made and use it to transform our system. That is to say that education is studying God's creation, how it works, and use it and advance or develop human existence. On the other hand, to restore the dignity of man. which is University of Nigeria Mogi, to promote excellence, knowledge, and live a better life. To restore the dignity of man, which means man lost their dignity. It happened in the Garden of Eden. And there is need for a restoration. But I want to give you hope that the dignity of man has been restored in Christ fully. But we need to explore it by education, proper information, so that the dignity of man will actually be restored in the way we remember God, the Creator who has made of his co-creators. Wisdom comes from God. It is taking us back to reasoning, wisdom age, where we can think and create out things by getting ideas. It is said that ideas rule the world. Proverbs 3:19-23 says, the Lord by wisdom has founded the earth. By understanding has he established the heavens. By his knowledge, the depth are broken up, and the cloud drop down the dew. My son, let them not depart from your eyes. Keep sound wisdom and discretion. So shall they be life unto your soul and grace to your neck. Then shall you walk in your way safely, and your foot shall not stumble. When you get sound wisdom, you will not stumble. You will walk smoothly. In the beginning, God, if I know how he restored a formless system, I can be able to apply the same measure in restoring any hopeless situation. To restore the dignity of man, we must understand how God addressed the issue of a formless world, and it became a wonderful world. What is a system? It is an organized set of ideas or theories or a particular way of doing something. A human or an animal body, or a part of it when it is being thought of as the organs and processes that make it function. Rules or people that control a country or organization. In the one, God created the light. God said, let there be light. He met a challenge and he declared a standard. He said, light here means solution. And as we know, education is light. Education is light. God said, let there be light. Which means, let there be a way out. Let there be a standard. Example of excellence, diligence, discretion, intelligence, integrity, understanding, among others. Let there be a future. Let there be a way out. So education is with which problems are solved. His life is the light. So my minimum standard should be the life of Christ. He is the light of the world. His life is life. So, light is very, very important. We should not be knowledge collectors or information gatherers without doing anything with them. Many people are just gathering knowledge without using it. In the tool, God created the environment, which means space with air. That's a living environment for life. There you find oxygen, carbon dioxide, and so on. The discipline created here is called atmospheric chemistry or chemistry department. We want to tell you that everything we are learning in school, God created them, and we are just, if you are a professor, you are just a professor in an aspect of what God has created. The third day he created the dry land, he separated water from the land. There, we are two disciplines here. Geoscience, the study of rocks, canals, and botany. Biology told us about two types of seed, flowering seed and non-flowering seed. God created herbs that bear fruit and trees that bear fruit. The scientists discovered their own through research, but Christians or believers discovered theirs by revelation. The fourth, plants. He created plants, the branch of science called many haphazard buildings. Oh, I talked about that one. The light of the world is meant to do something that can bring about change. Remove Christ from the system and you will have crisis, criminals, crimes, and suicidal thoughts as a result of hopelessness. Many people are dying because they don't have hope. In Genesis 5, God created birds. Europeans, they looked at bird, observed bird, and created a mechanical bird called aeroplane. They used stethoscope to observe how birds fly. The discipline here is called aviation or aviary, which is processes and procedures which God has created. Nigerians are consumers. We don't want it again. That's why we are looking at superlative campaign for excellence. We want to start creating things. Birds started in Africa, but Africans will observe birds to kill and eat. But what the white will observe and use the principle to make or to create helicopters, jumbo jets, among others. They see man, God created man. He said, let us make man in our own image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over everything created. Over everything. So you are created in the image of God. Some people, biology will tell you that we are animals. And that's why so many of them are behaving like animals. They sleep around, they do anything because they believe that they're animals. You are not an animal. You have an image of God, the creator. And he has given you the ability to create things. You need to know that. So the discipline here is biology and other disciplines that studies human behavior and human parts. That is where biological sciences and social sciences belong. You cannot be studying what God in his wisdom has created and you turn to say there is no God. It's a fool that says there is no God. Even the suicidal thoughts came as a result that one thinks he or she is worthless. You are not worthless. You are created with self-worth. So you need to understand this, that you have self-worth. Then the seventh, God rested. He worked 6 days and rested the seventh day. That is even where we got sabbatical leave. Because some people want to change so many things, want to argue what the Bible is saying, because they don't believe in it. But everything you see people are arguing with, we are originated from the Bible. The discipline here is health and physical education. Rest relaxes your brain, it calms your nerves. When you relax yourself, you get more energy for future work. Emotion is not, it will not help us. Some will tell you sharp 7 times and you become a millionaire. But if you want to be a millionaire, you must learn how millionaires speak. If you want wisdom, come to wisdom. All disciplines are geared to solving one problem or the other. Think of political science, arts, theater arts, medicine, and all the courses you are doing here, they are to solve man's problem. That's why you need diligence. If after going through the university and you do not have substance to show your light to your world, you have failed God. You will not fail God. You have something to show. We are here today to learn and bring positive change to our rotten systems. God is the answer, and we are his ambassadors. We are here in his name, therefore, he does not need to come down to change things why I am here. You don't need to wait for God to come down. If we must restore the dignity of man, we must do something. We must do something. He's not going to come down to do it for us. Make it a decision that your light must shine brighter each day of your life. You must fulfill your destiny and die a celebrity. We are all here to contact the light, to be educated, so we can make positive impact. Some, instead of getting the light, became darkened. That's why we're here, because there are a lot of confusion going on in the campus. And before we end up this program, you will see all of them, and you will be able to make the right choices for your life. This is the reason for this gathering, that you may be enlightened on the purpose you are enrolled in this great citadel. As you pursue your career, may you contact the light that will illuminate Nigeria, Africa, and the entire world. Stay in tune, and you will ever live to glorify God. Thanks, and remain blessed.
Wow. Wow. I think it's good. Some of you don't have jotter or even pen. Please try and capture this information. It will help you a great deal. A lot has been said that you should take dominion Turn to somebody by your side and say, take dominion.
Take dominion.
You are saying it as if you are not sure of yourself.
Turn to somebody and say, take dominion.
Take dominion.
Turn to the person and say, I am a salt
of the earth.
I am a salt of the earth.
I am a light to the world.
We are looking at academic excellence, the secret to academic success. That's what we want to look at. And I want to say that for you to succeed, you are the determinant. Tell yourself, I am the determinant. If you want to succeed in life, you must be determined to succeed. The first day you enter this campus, you are to determine whether you be a best class material, or second class, or third class, or attended university. There are people that will pass through the university, and lo and behold, their certificate has attended university. You know that in this life, there's seed time and harvest. It cannot cease. So your being in school now is your sowing period, and you need to determine your end from today. That's why we organize this program urgently, so that we call back your mind, your attention to what you have come here to do, so you can be able to decide whether you are a first class material or a second class material or whatever. In today's society, there is increasing pressure on young people to attend post-secondary and higher level of education. There are pressure many people are aspiring to come. Education is considered imperative for the progress of the individuals and the development of communities and nations. Individuals need to generate awareness and enhance their educational system. You need to be aware. In many countries, including Nigeria, there are entry requirements that permit valid student selection decisions to be made. Admission is secured through UTME and post-UTME screening exercises. Besides, Nigeria's higher education sector has been overburdened by strong population growth and a significant youth bulge. There are a lot of people seeking for admission. I want you to tell your neighbor congratulations for being able to make it to this great citadel. Congratulations. I want to congratulate you once again. Besides, there is expansion of the nation's higher education sector in recent decades. It has failed to accommodate the booming demand. Thank God you were accommodated. As a consequence, substantial number of UBE college and university students are turned away from getting admission, but you are blessed to be here. In the university, students have motives, intentions, and expectations who will interact with their learning activities. There are people that are inwardly motivated. Those people, they achieve a lot. There are people, their intention for coming to school is just to answer that I'm a university student or I'm a graduate of a university. That's just the reason for their being here. They actively engage in learning with the intention of attaining understanding and intellectual development. In contrast, students who are explicit motives and are only focused on achieving external goals and desires, they don't achieve much. If you are internally motivated, you achieve a lot. So you need to be internally motivated for you to achieve a lot, because there will be a lot of distractions which you will need to handle for you to be able to achieve. Transition from secondary school to post-secondary school is a challenge for some of you. Some of you have been eating your father's food, but as they are handing in your certificate, they will tell you that because you are worthy, both in character and in learning, that's why you are receiving this certificate. And you need to look into this character. So well, we have a lot of people that can advance you academically, but we don't have much or
people that can help you build your character are few. And that's why we need to tell you something on time. What are the... Academic excellence begins with good character. What is character? It may be referred as features that make up and distinguish an individual from others. Your success or failure always results from how you respond to life situations and circumstances. I teach first years in my faculty human behavior, the way you respond to the society, the behaviors that attract punishment, those that doesn't attract punishment, and so on and so forth. So the way you respond to situation, your ability to cope with challenges will determine whether you will make it or not. I want to tell you, I am a woman that have made up my mind that despite the challenge I have, I will succeed. My mother died when 1993, I was very small, being the first child. Nobody to assist, but I made up my mind that I will, through hard work, building myself gradually till I get to the pinnacle of God's purpose in my life. And I want you to make such a determination that you will make it. There are qualities that make up what character is. Discretion, recognizing and avoiding words, actions, and attitudes that could bring undesirable consequences. Getting wrong desires and doing what is right, you must be able to know what is right and what is wrong, and be able to resist the one that is wrong and do the right one. Because the wrong one will always attract punishment. Diligent, investing your time and energy to complete each task assigned to you. You must make sure everything you are asked to do, your assignment, attending classes and so forth, that you are diligent in attending all of them. These are the things that will determine whether you will make it or not. Attendance is compulsory, you know it. Attendance 10 marks, assignment 10 marks, test 10 marks, that's 30 marks for continuous assessment, and 70 marks for exam. That will make it 100%. So if you want to fail, it starts from the first day in your class. So you have to be serious. That's why we are bringing this. You have to be diligent. You have responsibility. Knowing and doing what is expected of you. Determination, I've told you. Proposing to accomplish right goals. Right goals. Mark that word. Right goals. At the right time. At the right time. Regardless of difficulties. Regardless of difficulties. You must make up your mind to do so. Also, students with good character are expected to have respect for the constituted authority. When they send you to the registrar, no man's report you, he will tell you so many pitfalls. How students are holding their files, and it won't allow them to graduate because they think they can play the university. They will ask you to register your course. You will not register. And you will keep your file. You will wait. Waiting until when you get A in that course, you will not say, I want to add and drop. And when you do that, you will miss it. The university will find you at the end, and you have yourself to be blamed. So,
party with restriction or control. Many people, when they enter school, they will not feel relaxed. None of their parents is here to restrict their movement again. So they are now free. They are now in the free world. So they can behave anyhow. If you do that, you will enjoy yourself. You will enjoy yourself. Avoid cohabitation and fornication. Many students are living together without paying their bride prices. Some of them, they will get pregnant along the line without anything being done on their head, and so many things. In fact, one of my students told me a story of her roommate. She just entered school. And all of a sudden, a young guy came every time. He's clustering around her. And then, do you know what the young guy used to attract her heart? That he has his twin sister. This twin sister looks like that you are just like my twin sister. And then, every evening, he will come and call her on phone. They will keep talking.
from hostel to house, and the girl, now she no longer sleeps in her house. She's now sleeping in the boy's house. Is that what you come here to do? Avoid stealing or peeping. Avoid substance abuse and addiction. Avoid trying to hide yourself. You know, when some people take in their hand or some hard drugs is that they want to be high. You don't need all those things. You need something that will calm your brain so you can be able to relax, read your books, and make it. That's why you're here. Don't go and join people that will induce you, smoke, do this and that. Those things will harm you. They will enjoy you. Your character is important for success in your life because it determines if you are a businessman. You don't have money to start the business. You have hunger to start a business and there's no money. And luckily to you, you find somebody that will release the goods for you. After selling, you return the money. And then after selling, instead of you returning the money, you now ate up the money. You now decided to eat the money. If you go back again, will the person give you the food again? So when you don't have good character, it will make people start running away from you. They can't trust you. When they give you money, you are not reliable. When you say you are coming, the person better go to market or go to a room and come back because you are not coming. You will say, you tell somebody you are coming, you are not coming. You are not reliable. Your character is not stable. With that, you can't succeed. Your character has to be stable. Students, university, academic expectations. First of all, you have to know yourself. Know when it is better for you to read. Some people cannot read under the sun. In a harsh weather, they can't read. So for me, I assimilate better between 2 p.m. and 2 a.m.
and 5 a.m. in the morning.
So you have to know yourself. Which best will I read and then be able to understand, digest, and assimilate so that you won't be struggling with your studies. Just know who you are, know yourself, and then be able to manage yourself. Don't be a copycat. Many people always copy. And if you're a copycat, you can't be a producer. You can't be a co-creator, which God has destined for you. Some of you will pay somebody to write projects for you, write seminars for you, workshop for you. If you are paying for everything, how will you now learn? How will you now teach the coming ones? You know that life is like a relay race. You know what I mean by relay race. As you are running, you hand over the baton to the next generation. If you don't know anything, what will you add? What will you hand over to the next generation? So you need to get yourself a size so that you acquire the skills that is required. If you're a medical doctor and you graduated with the medical certificate and you cannot do operation, you cannot do what you came to do very well, you will be killing people. Instead of adding to the society, you are taking away. It will not be your portion. Read your textbooks or materials related to your course outlined before the lecture. It will help you to know where you have issues. Engage lecturer. Time, we have talked about time. Then when we come to the issue of going to fellowship, some people will tell you, you didn't come here for fellowship. It's true, you came here for academics, but you need to know that apart from God, you can do nothing. The best place to refresh yourself after a hectic day is the place of fellowship. But you don't have to make fellowship. From morning to night, you are going to fellowship. If you belong to a vibrant church, where they teach you the truth, yeah, they have confession schools, they have different ways to grow in your faith, depending on your denomination or whatever. When you now come to fellowship should be just a gathering that will bring people together and make you people help one another, relate with one another as people that has one faith. And And it should not be more than 1 hour 30 minutes. You should make it snappy and short, perhaps once in a week, so that you can be fully active in your church. Some of you have made fellowship church, and some of you will not be under leaders that don't have mentors. They will be messing you around. Some, in fact, I have a student that told me that he had some group of guys. They want to go for prayer in the mountain, and after prayer, they will start touching themselves. And before you know it, something else has started happening. So you need to be careful. The way you move with people, when they are crossing boundary, you have to be careful. Do your assignment on time and hand it as requested. Always attend lectures on time. Ask questions on things you do not understand. Study back questions. Study back questions. This will help you to find out the way your lecturer asks questions and how you can approach it. If you don't understand, you go ahead and ask him before your exam. Read through your lecture notes after lectures. Don't postpone it. Some of you will wait until exam before you start reading. And when you wait, the whole thing will be jam-packed and you will no longer be able to assimilate. You will not try to cope up and you will see that you are stressed out and you still will lead you to exam tension, exam fever and so on and so forth. You are no longer comfortable because you are now under pressure. Don't allow yourself to work under pressure. Find the best way to memorize your notes. So do that through great acronyms for each topic. For those of us that are in social sciences, we create acronyms. Just find the best way of mastering your formulas and so on and so forth, so that from time to time you revise it, and it will help you to get familiar with that particular topic. Select good friends that will advance your life. You have pesky killers. We have pesky killers, but we have pesky helpers. Find those people that will help you. Anybody that will distract you, set the person aside. Set goals for yourself, prioritize your activities. God first has told you, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and the rest will be added to you. Your reading time, your leisure time, exercise yourself. Do exercises. Avoid distractions of deceivers like boyfriends, girlfriends that will lead to sexual relationship outside marriage. Too much socialization will distract you. So we want you to be focused as you are here on campus. Always take rest after a hectic day before carrying your book for studying again. Early morning reading helps one to assimilate better. I thought about that one. Did you know that? By so doing, you will avoid embarrassment. Okay, you have to do what your lecturer asks you to do on time. When you have read, pray. Believe that you can make it. God, through His Holy Spirit, will remind you what you have read during the exam. And He will make you to write well. People will be very far away from you when you do all these things. You confidently take charge of the atmosphere in your class when you enter. Don't allow anyone to distract you. That will help you. So when you are confident in yourself, you will enter into the exam hall and you will come out successfully. Then, when you enter into an exam hall, read the instructions carefully. Make sure you start with the number you know very well. You can answer them correctly. Start with such number. When you finish, list all the numbers you answered. List all the numbers answered at the first page, and then proceed. Use 10 minutes to read through your work. Check the fences, the bars, and make sure that what you are writing flows. When the lecturer understands what you are reading, the lecturer will be very happy to read your work and mark your book. And once you are asked to stand up, stand and hand in your paper. Don't hand in your paper late, because some of you, they will now abandon your book, your paper with you, and you will be crying. So please, I want you to know that your coming here is not in vain. Your coming here is not in vain. Do not fall victim of any exam malpractice. It will hurt you and you have yourself to be blamed. When you do all these things, use your internet properly, you will have good success. May the Lord give you grace. as you embarked on this journey you have begun. As graduates in the making, it is expected that you inspect the primary mission of the school, which is to restore the dignity of man rooted in a set of values, hard work, service, social justice, dignity, and worth of the person, importance of human relationship, integrity, and competence in everything you do. So as you journey in this University of Nigeria Nsukka, in pursuit of your academic career, be God-fearing, be God-oriented, be guided at all times. Journey well, great lions and lionesses. Receive grace to excel. Thank you so much.
You are clapping as if you do not appreciate her kind words. I would like you to do a little exercise, please. Can you stand up and give her a resounding appreciation? Please, can we clap for her? Stand up and appreciate her. Thank you so much. They sent you to the registrar of the University of Nigeria, Mr. Martin Arumede. Can we give it up for him, please? Put your hands together for him.
Great lions and lionesses. You're welcome to this program. This program is a campaign. The essence of the campaign is that so many people walk into the university without knowing the reason why they are here. When the admission comes out, it's a thrill of joy. But unfortunately, my HOD told me years back that it's not everybody that enters university that will go out with a certificate.